Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic LODR regulations. So LODR regulations, it is a very important topic for your Sebi grade examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let's begin. So first of all, we will log into our website anujindal.in. So here I'll log into this link. So here you can see in the quizzes section, quizzes are available for different examinations like RBI Grade B, SEBI, UGC NET, NABARD. So I'll go to SEBI Grade A. So you can see quizzes are available for different topics. So you can attempt these quizzes. So today I'm going to discuss Securities Market LODR Regulations. So start quiz. So let us see the first question. LODR regulations contain provisions for listed entities. Consider the below statements. So here you are given three statements. You have to see which of them are correct and which of them are not. So statement one, a director cannot be a member in more than 10 committees and the chairperson of more than 5 committees across all listed entities. So first of all, you must be very clear that LODR regulations, they are only for listed entities or listed companies, right? Now statement one is saying that a director cannot be a member in more than 10 committees and the chairperson of more than 5 committees. So this statement one, it is correct because as per the LODR regulations 2015, so these regulations are of the year 2015. This is also important. So this statement is correct. A director cannot be a member in more than 10 committees and chairperson of more than 5 committees. Statement one is right. Then statement two, a person cannot serve as an independent director in more than 7 listed entities. This statement is also correct. So the regulations state that a person cannot be an independent director in more than 7 entities, and if the person is managing director or whole time director in any listed entity, then he cannot be an independent director in more than 3 listed entities. So this limit of 7 gets reduced to 3 if the person is an MD or whole time director in a listed entity, right? So there are two limits, 7 and 3. 3 is for the person who is MD or whole time director in any listed company. So statement 2 is also correct. And statement 3, if the chairperson of BOD, BOD means Board of Directors. So if the chairperson of Board of Directors is an executive director, then board should comprise of at least 1/3 independent directors. So regulation 17 of the LODR regulations, they talk about the composition of board in a listed entity. So as per these regulations, if the chairperson or chairman is an executive director, then at least 1/2 of the directors should be independent directors. But if the chairperson is a non-executive director, then at least 1/3 of the directors should be independent. But if the chairperson is non-executive, but he is a promoter or member of promoter group, then in that case also, at least 1/2 of the directors should be independent. So the question is asking you, if the chairperson is executive, then board should comprise of at least 1/3 independent directors. So this statement is incorrect. Why? Because if the chairperson is executive, then at least 1/2 of the directors should be independent directors. So statement 3 is incorrect. So the question is asking you which of the above statements are incorrect. So you can see only statement 3, it is incorrect. So the correct option is option D, statement 3. Moving on, question 2. Consider the below statements. Statement 1, with effect from 1st April 2019, a person can be a director in at most 7 listed entities. So as per the regulations, with effect from 1st April 2019, a person can be a director in maximum 8 listed entities, and with effect from 1st April 2020, a person can be director in at most 7 listed entities. So statement 1 is incorrect because with effect from 1st April 2019, the maximum directorships for a person in listed entities is 8 and not 7. 7 is with effect from 1st April 2020. So statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 2, board of directors of a listed entity shall meet at least 3 times in a year with a maximum gap of 120 days between 2 meetings. So this statement is again incorrect. Why? Because as per regulation 17 of LODR regulations, the board of directors must meet at least 4 times in a year. So it is at least 4 times and the maximum gap should be 120 days. So the second part of the statement is correct, but the first part is not correct, right? So statement 2 is also incorrect. And statement 3, with effect from 1st April 2020, chairperson of the board of top 500 listed entities must be a non-executive director who is not related to MD or CEO. So this statement is right. So there were some recent amendments made in these LODR regulations. So as per these amendments, with effect from 1st April 2020, top 500 listed entities, not top 500 in terms of market capitalization. So top 500 in terms of market capitalization as at the end of previous financial year, right? So the chairperson of the top 500 listed entities must be a non-executive director who is not related to MD or CEO with effect from 1st April 2020. So statement 3 is right. Now the question is asking you which of the above statements are correct. So you can see only statement 3, it is correct. So the correct option is option D, only statement 3. Now moving to the next question, question 3. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, important information regarding examinations is being shared. So do join the group and get the benefit. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. So question 3, as per LODR regulations 2015, every listed entity is required to formulate a vigil mechanism for directors and employees to report genuine concerns. Also, the mechanism should provide access to dash in appropriate cases. So regulation 22 of LODR regulations, they talk about vigil mechanism. So as per regulation 22, every listed entity is required to have a vigil mechanism. So this mechanism basically allows directors and employees to report concerns. So they can report any wrongdoing, misconduct or fraud which may be happening in a company. So this mechanism provides the directors or employees a mechanism to report such cases, and also the company must ensure that these directors or employees, they are not victimized or harassed. So their safety must be ensured, and also they must not be fired from their jobs. So this vigil mechanism, you can also say it is like a whistleblower mechanism where the employees of the company can report genuine concerns or other frauds also. So these employees or directors should be provided access to chairman or chairperson of the audit committee. So access should be provided to chairperson of the audit committee in appropriate or exceptional cases. So regulation 22 talks about that. So the correct option here is option E, chairperson of audit committee. Moving to the next question, question 4. LODR regulations contain provisions for audit committee in a listed entity. So regulation 18 of LODR regulations 2015, they talk about the formation of audit committee in a listed entity. So before discussing this question, I would also like to tell you that this regulation 17 was regarding composition of board. Then regulation 18 regarding audit committee. Then there is regulation 19 also regarding nomination and remuneration committee. And then regulation 20, 21, 22, 23. So these regulations, they are applicable on listed entities, as I told you. But these regulations, they are not applicable on those listed entities who have paid up equity share capital up to rupees 10 crore and net worth up to rupees 25 crore. So these regulations, they are not applicable on those listed entities whose paid up equity share capital does not exceed rupees 10 crore and whose net worth does not exceed rupees 25 crore. So basically you can see these regulations are not applicable on small listed entities, right? So now let us see the statements. Statement 1, minimum 1/2 of the members should be independent directors. So statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because as per regulation 18, minimum 2/3 of the members should be independent directors. So statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 2, the chairperson of the audit committee must be an independent director. So this statement is right. The chairperson must be independent. Statement 3, all the members should have financial expertise. Now this statement is wrong. Why? Because all the members should be financially literate, not experts. And financial literate means that they should be able to read and understand financial statements like balance sheet, profit and loss account, cash flow statement. So all the members should have financial literacy, not expertise. But at least one member should be financially expert, not all. So statement 3 is incorrect. And statement 4, audit committee must meet at least 4 times in a year. So this statement is right. So audit committee must meet at least 4 times in a year, and the gap between two meetings, it should not exceed 120 days. So both these things. And this regulation is the same as for a board meeting. In the meeting of board of directors also, there must be at least 4 meetings and the maximum gap can be 120 days. So the regulations regarding the meetings of audit committee and the meeting of BOD is the same. So statement 4 is right. So question is asking you which of the above statements are incorrect. So you can see statement 1 and statement 3, they are incorrect. So the correct option is option E, statement 1 and 3. Now moving on to the last question, question 5. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also posted a quiz on this topic on our website. So I have also posted quizzes on other topics for our Sebi grade examination. So do visit the website and attempt those quizzes to see your preparation level. The link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now fifth question, let us read the question. What is the name of the Sebi online grievance redressal system where investors can file complaints? So your options are Satark, Beware, Scores, Sachet and Sashat. So I'm not going to tell you the answer to this question now. So post the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards I will post the correct answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.